Hi, I'm Dr. Jenny Gray. I'm the Chief Executive Officer of Zoos Victoria. I'm standing at one of our most popular places in the zoo, right next to the butterfly house. But what many of you don't know is what's happening in the back of the butterfly house. So I'm going to take you behind the scenes. Come with me. I've got some interesting people to introduce you to and some amazing creatures to share stories with. Here we are at the Lord Howe Island sticky insect breeding facility, and I've just found Rowan.
Hi, Jenny.
Rowan is the world's leading expert in this animal and has been an incredibly important part of the journey to save the Lord Howe Island sticky insects. On this side of the breeding house, we actually have eggs, which are in these incredible containers down the back there.
On this side, this is where we put all our nymphs. As soon as they hatch, they come into these enclosures here.
So every day you come into work and it's like, surprise, yeah. Baby sticky insects.
A new baby pretty much every day, sometimes a dozen, sometimes less than that, but it's going.
We met Rowan earlier when we were in the hothouse, and on my way here, I bumped into Kate. Kate Pierce is the coordinator for ectotherms, hold that word, and Rowan is the leading expert in Lord Howe Island stick insects. And I've asked them both to join me for a few minutes just to chat about this program, where it started, where it's going. But Kate, to warm up, what's an ectotherm?
Ectotherms are a big group of species, so they include reptiles, amphibians and invertebrates. So they're species that can't create their own body heat. So mammals and birds like us, we can create our own heat, whereas those species rely on external environments, so the sun, to generate heat.
So what's so special about them?
I think the backstory is absolutely wonderful. Presumed extinct for nearly 80 years, found on this absolutely incredible rock close to Lord Howe Island, and it's just a find of the century, last century for sure.
And Kate, that background, why did we think they'd gone extinct? What happened on Lord Howe Island?
So a ship ran aground called the Macambo in 1918, and black rats swam onto shore, and basically they'd eaten the lot within a decade or so. They were presumed extinct for around 80 years. And then in 2001, a team of scientists from New South Wales rediscovered them on Ball's Pyramid.
So Kate, you in a unique position. You're one of the few people on this planet that's actually been to Ball's Pyramid. Describe that. What's it like as you're approaching Ball's Pyramid?
So I'd met quite a few people that had been to Ball's Pyramid, and they talked about how amazing this place was. And as you round the corner of Lord Howe Island heading out towards Ball's Pyramid, it takes your breath away. And I didn't know if I was actually going to get onto Ball's Pyramid. And then I was given a couple of seconds notice and I just had to jump in. But we made it there and I managed to climb all the way up there onto Ball's Pyramid. It was amazing.
So Ball's Pyramid, I'm sure people are wondering why you jumped in the ocean and you didn't just get off at a pier. There isn't one. It's just a rock coming straight out of the ocean, incredibly inhospitable, and on a bush. And then I also learned the bush isn't a little bush, it's a very big bush. But Rowan, that's where they found the last remnant population.
Yeah, they did, and the decision was made by that team to actually send two of the best climbers up at night. And lo and behold, they found a living specimen, which was just incredible.
And they brought them back to the mainland, and that's where you guys really step in to the story. Is the ectotherm team at Melbourne Zoo were given this incredible responsibility of looking and researching a species that had been presumed extinct for 80 years. Tell us about that.
Yeah, that's right. And it actually took 2 years to get everything agreed. And then a pair arrived at Melbourne Zoo on the 16th of February 2003. And we lovingly named them Adam and Eve, and they were start of the breeding program. And we knew we had one chance, and one chance only. So, you know, some very, very careful decisions were made at that point, and they're still being made today.
Now, it always sounds easy to say you bring in a pair from the wild and then we bred them, but it's very difficult to understand exactly what they need in order to thrive. And so that took you guys some sleepless nights?
It certainly did, and it took a number of years before we actually cracked things really well on how to actually house them, breed them and everything. They are, as Kate mentioned earlier, environmental conditions are critical to this species.
Now, all the kids who are listening, in terms of if you want to save a species in the future, it's about this. It's about hard work. It's about paying attention to detail and really studying hard so you can do this. But Kate, we got it right. And what does the situation look like right now?
So at the moment we have around 500 individuals on site at any one time. We also had a female that was collected in 2017, so that was the trip that I was very lucky to be able to go on with the Australian Museum and the Lord Howe Island Board. So the additional female was called Vanessa, and we're now introducing her genetics into the original population. So we're seeing a more robust population.
So Rowan, it's easy to think about this being about genetics and getting the animals in, but that's really just the beginning. It's important to have the right environment, as you mentioned, the right hothouses, but things like food and natural behaviours are also really important, and you're doing a lot of work on that.
We put a lot of effort into researching the species and what's optimum for them. And with our horticulture team here at Zoos Victoria, you know, we've got a great team that work and grow all the plants for us. They are very specific with what they eat. And I'm really happy to announce that we are now feeding only endemic plants off Lord Howe Island, which has taken a number of years to get to.
And that's because for us, success is not animals in hothouses. For us, success is animals back on Lord Howe Island, living the lives that they really evolved to live. So Kate, what's next?
So the main threatening process for the Lord Howe Island stick insects was an introduced predator, so the rats. And we're really lucky that the rodent eradication program has now been completed. We've also got a more genetically robust population here at Melbourne Zoo. So we're really hopeful that we can see them back in their island paradise.
As you can see, there's a whole lot of things happening behind the scenes, really focused on fighting extinction and making sure that species survive well into the future. These days, Zoos Victoria is a very large conservation organization. What you've seen with the Lord Howe Island stick insect is the work that we undertake for just one of 27 critically endangered species that we work with each and every day to make sure that no Victorian terrestrial vertebrate species go extinct on our watch.